Hello students, today we will begin with third lesson, Force and Pressure, Lecture 1. Students, just recall yourself. What is a force? Force is a physical quantity. Push and pull on an object is a force in a simple language. And due to application of force, object comes in motion. Students, a stationary object on which no force is acting remains stationary, that is, in a particular position until and unless force is applied on it. An object in motion continues to move with the same speed and direction when no force is acting on the object. This is Newton's first law of motion. And student, this Newton's law you will be studying in class 9 in detail. Now, observe the pictures given below here. Now, contact and non-contact forces. In figure first, a car moves in forward direction when a man applies force from behind. In second figure, a reluctant, that is naughty dog, is being pulled by his master. While in third figure, a boy playing football, it's kicking the ball away. So students, what do you observe from these? So here you can see the application of force. So a force acts on two bodies through an interaction, that is influence between them. So students, just let's see this figure once again. So in the first figure, when a man pushed the car, he touches the car, that is, there is touch between man and the car. In second figure, boy pulls the dog. So to pull the dog, he pulls that string. So here also, there is a touch between boy and string. Similarly, in third figure, when a boy kicks the ball, he touches the ball. So here also, there is a touch between leg of boy and the ball. So students, from these examples, we come to know that a force acts on the two bodies through an interaction between them. Now, in this figure, you can see that the nails have got attracted to the poles of a magnet due to magnetic force. Here, you can see that the coconut is falling from a coconut tree due to Earth's gravitational force. When a comb gets rubbed against hair, small pieces of paper kept on a table get attracted to the comb. This is because the comb has an electrostatic charge and there is an induced, that is produced, opposite charge on the pieces of paper and the pieces stick to the comb. In this figure, a force is seen to act through a direct contact of the objects or via one more object. Such a force is called contact force. I repeat, a force is seen to act through a direct contact of the objects or via one or more object. Such a force is called contact force. Now, in this figure, a force is applied between two objects. Even if the two objects are not in contact, such a force is called a non-contact force. I repeat, a force is applied between two objects, even if the two objects are not in contact. Such a force is called a non-contact force. Students, muscular force is an example of contact force and is applied to the objects with the help of our muscles. It is applied in several cases such as lifting, pushing and pulling. On the contrary, forces like magnetic force, gravitational force, electrostatic force act without a contact. Therefore, these are the examples of non-contact forces. When a ball is kept on a table and pushed a little, it moves ahead and gets slow and stops. A car running on a plain road travels some distance and stops after the engine is switched off. This is because of the force of friction between the ground surface and the object in motion. In the absence of frictional force, the object would have remained in motion. Frictional force is very useful in daily life. While walking, we push the ground with our feet. Here, while walking, you can see that the motion is in forward direction and friction is in backward direction. In short, we push the ground behind with our feet. In the absence of friction, we will slip and will not able to walk. All the objects in motion have a frictional force acting on them, which is acting in the direction opposite to the direction of motion. You must have seen that one tends to slip over banana peel on the street. Similarly, one can slip due to mud. Both these examples occur due to reduced friction. Now, today's homework is: first, write and learn spellings of stationary, reluctant, interaction, electrostatic, and friction. Second, write and learn definitions of contact force and non-contact force. Third, write few more examples of contact and non-contact force. And fourth, write types of forces. Thank you, children.